Hello everyone, my name is Sam. In this tutorial, I'm gonna be showing you how to make a double exposure design in Photoshop. Before getting started, please do me a favor by subscribing to this channel and you'll get my future uploads for free. Without further ado, let's begin. What we're gonna do first is to create a new document with a 4:3 ratio of image size. So it will be 4096 by 3072 pixels with 300 pixels per inch and RGB color mode. Then click create. Next, drag the model into the canvas. If you need to resize the image, press and hold the Alt and Shift keys while dragging the size control right away. Then adjust the position as well. If you finish, click the checkmark icon. Then select the background layer, click this icon, and select solid color. Give any color you want for the background and click OK. You might also want to delete the white background layer, so click this padlock icon, right-click on it, and select delete layer. Click OK. Alright, now we are going to cut out the model image from its background, so select the model layer, then activate the quick selection tool. If you are using the Photoshop CC, click the select subject to make a selection over the model automatically. However, the automatic subject selection might not be working perfectly sometimes, so you might also need to fix the selection using the quick selection tool. And click this icon in case you need to subtract other minimal areas from the selection. But if you are using Photoshop CS, you need to select the subject manually. Next, I'm going to refine the edges of the selection around the hair and the hat spool. So go to select. For Photoshop CS, select refine edge, maybe around here. But for Photoshop CC, head over your cursor onto the select and mask while pressing and holding the shift key on your keyboard, then click on it to open the refine edge dialog box. Here you can choose any view mode that you are more clearly looking at the edges. Here I choose the overlay view mode, then set the radius amount to around 8. Play with your square bracket keys to enlarge or minimize the brush size and brush around the edges you are going to refine, such as around the hat fur and the hair edges as well. Then I'm going to switch to the on white view mode to find out whether there is still background color left over. If there is, tick the decontaminate colors checkbox and play with the mount gauge until the leftovers get reduced, maybe to around 50. Then select output to new layer with layer mask and click OK. I think I need to erase the leftovers manually, so select the layer mask, activate the brush tool, make sure the foreground color is black, set the brush hardness to around 30% with 100% flow, 100% opacity, and 100% smoothing. Then brush around the leftovers to erase them. Usually the Refine Edge brush tool causes blurriness, so I need to duplicate the subject layer, then select both copies by holding the Ctrl key while clicking on them, right click and select merge layers. Next, what we're gonna do is to add a black and white adjustment layer, so click this icon and select black and white. You might want to click the auto add the properties box, then right-click on it and select Create Clipping Mask so that it applies only to the model layer. You might also want to adjust the color settings by clicking this icon, then select the red gauge to turn the red colors of the model image either to black or white. Try to experiment with other sliders as well to get the black and white tone you want for the model image. Now it's time to add the second image onto the canvas. Adjust the size and position. If you want a more precise position, reduce its opacity for a while, activate the move tool, and move the image position until you get an overlapping as you want. Press Ctrl T if you need to resize it again. I think this is a good overlapping view for me. If you are done, click this checkmark. Then set the opacity back to 100%, right click on it, and select Create Clipping Mask. Then set the blending mode to light tone for the second image. To be clear, I changed the name to image 2 and image 1 for the model image. Then give a layer mask for image 2 by clicking this icon. We will use this layer mask later to reduce the exposure of image 2 around the face area by brushing its clipping mask with black. But before so, you might also want to adjust the color tone for the model to match the image 2 color tone by reducing the opacity of the black and white layer. Let's back to the image 2 layer mask, activate brush tool. Make sure the foreground color is black. You can click this icon to reverse between foreground and background color or simply clicking the X button on your keyboard. Play with your square bracket keys to adjust the brush size. Set the flow amount to around 20%. Select the soft round brush preset with 0% of hardness. And here we go. Brush around the model areas that you want to expose more. So take your time to do so. In this demonstration, I speed up this step to shorten the duration of this video. As the opposite trick, if you want to expose some areas of the second image more, change the foreground color to white and brush them. So, brush with black to expose the model and brush with white to expose the second image. And the last step but not least, add a curves adjustment layer and click this icon to make it a clipping mask. Slide up the upper part of the axis to bring up the highlight areas more standout. Slide down the bottom part of the axis to bring up the dark or shadow areas more standout. Take your time to tinker with this curves adjustment layer to get the color tone you want for your double exposure design. And finally, this is what we get. Alright, that's all for this tutorial. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you have something to ask, please let me know in the comment section below. Please like this video and hit the subscribe button for more future uploads. Thanks for watching this video and see you!